Welcome to Q&A Thursday. I am your coach, Tandar Tanaboli. Today's topic is how to stand back up after a fall. Let's begin. Lately, every time I try to pick myself up after a bad event, I feel out of energy and like a failure. I have a very hard time getting motivated to pick up and start again. I think, what's the point? I know life has ups and downs, but how do you re-energize to keep moving forward? Thank you for writing in. That's a great question, as I know a lot of people will benefit from the solutions I'm about to offer. And before we begin, I'd like to mention that success is supposed to be difficult. And sometimes we forget that. The lows actually help us appreciate the highs more. And I know falling down is never easy, but there's always a good reason for it. And once you understand that, it's so much easier to get yourself re-energized and motivated and back up. So let's not keep you waiting and get to our first tip. Number one, change your angle of perception. You're looking at this from a very wrong angle. You think if you failed at something, then you must be a failure. When we fail in approaching a goal or achieving a dream and it doesn't happen, that does not automatically turn us into a failure. In my book, failing means two things. One is that you did give it a try. You did take action. You did experience it. Instead of sitting on the sidelines and saying, I wonder how that would feel like. I wonder if I did approach that. You left no room for what ifs. And that's the beauty of it. The second point is, you had to fall. You had to fall because there's a bigger lesson in it for it. Because you would have got something on a mediocre level. And when we fall, there's a great lesson that we learn and we can go back at it again and fine tune it and make it even bigger and better. So there's no losing and failing. And there's no labeling and failing either. You cannot label yourself as a failure. So when we're down at the rock bottom and we've fallen, that's the place where we rethink our strategies. We re-energize and stay there long enough to realize that we're not failures and we're gonna do this again and we're gonna do it in a different way. Michael Jordan has said that I've missed more than 9,000 shots in my career. I've lost almost 300 games, 26 times. I've been trusted to take the game-winning shot and missed. I've failed over and over again in my life, and that is why I succeed. So remember, no success comes without failure. Let's get to number two. Your lesson is down there. The key to opening the next door, to the next step that you need to take in order to become more successful in whatever goal you have set your mind to, is at the rock bottom. When people hit rock bottom, because of the pain of a loss, because of the pain of not winning, the first thing they want to do is numb the pain. What do? Drink, eat, do drugs excessively. That is all done to numb a pain. Instead, what I suggest you do is when you're hitting rock bottom, if you feel like you failed at something, you have to take your time when you're down. You have to nourish yourself. You have to give yourself love and do not rush to get back up until you have the lesson of why did this happen? What was I missing? Where did I go wrong so I can improve myself better? So grab your lesson, change your perception, and it becomes so much easier to get back up and on track. Which gets us to number three. Your circle matters. I know it's really hard when you fall. I've been there many times, and I know it wasn't the last, and I know it will keep continuing, as I have many goals that I like to achieve and there will be many fallen moments along the line. What you have to keep in mind though is that you don't have to do this alone. Surround yourself with like-minded people, with people with the same values, people who truly care about their goals. And I'm telling this from experience. The people you surround yourself who have the same experience as you, who have the same values as you, are the people who recognize your falling. And they're the ones who show up in your life and help you get back up. You don't have to do this alone, and why should you? So take a look at your circle and see who's really there for you. Number four, be happy for the successful. I know it's really hard when you're down at the bottom and you're looking at other people achieving and keep moving forward and gaining so much out of life. And here you are feeling really bad and you feel like you're at a loss. It's really hard to feel happy for the successful. So why do I say that? The moment you start feeling happy for the successful people, it's the moment you eliminate jealousy, you eliminate comparison. Once you're happy for other people, you also remind yourself that they have fallen many times too, and they will also fall, but these are the moments of their glory. When we fall in the beginning, we're angry, we're down, we're mad. Why this is happening? Why did this happen? Instead, you have to channel that energy into motivation and say, fine, I fell, but I don't want to give up now. I'm going to get back up again. One of the best advices I ever read by a mother to a daughter was Arianna Huffington's mom. She told her, failure is not the opposite of success. It is a stepping stone to success. Next time you're down, it's not where you're supposed to be staying. It's not supposed to be labeled on you. It's only a temporary stop for you to regroup, rethink, re-energize, and get creative to get back up and start charging towards your goals again. With that being said, that's all for the coaching tips for today. I hope they serve you well. And if you know someone who's going through the same situation as you, just go ahead and share the video with them. And for more coaching tips such as these, you can sign up at my YouTube channel or go to my website at tandartanawuli.com. I can't wait to see you all next week. Until then, keep happy and healthy.